doing events and venues with Work Hard, Play Hard makes my life better, yes.
This is awesome, you know, too much fun.
You need to get out and do things. You need other people.
It keeps me occupied, you know, keeps me busy.
And it's exciting because you're out of your element.
And we do have a lot of laughs.
And once they go, they're hooked. Play Hard program takes folks out in the community to attend different events. It allows our members to have access to community events without having to impact their finances. And it also shows the community that we can be part of the community, that we are a viable part of the community. We are consumers of the community also.
We get to go to UConn basketball games and football games.
I go to the movies once a month.
I like the bowling, the duck pin bowling. Yeah, the bowling is a lot of fun. Awesome, you know, you can't ask for more. So.
I go to pottery once a month. Then they go to Target once a month and the Waterford Commons, and we go shopping. And even if you can't buy anything, you can browse, and it's a lot of fun.
We go to billiards, local plays, and just plain old social events, shopping, things like that. So everybody gets a little taste of something that they like to do.
There's always something going on, and the people that I've met have been very, very nice.
Each one is its own antidote, each event you go to.
That's why I'm riding the rail.
I think it's definitely a barrier breaker.
I do get out in the community more because, see, transportation's a problem. I don't drive. And then finances are a problem. I wouldn't be able to afford to do the things I do with Work Hard, Play Hard.
Years ago, we were stigmatized really bad that nobody was tolerated if they had a mental illness. And I think that barrier is slowly eroding.
I think our program reduces stigma by letting community members see that, you know, we are who we are. I mean, they may think we are what they see on TV or what's portrayed of us in the media, which isn't always good. We're just people who like to go to movies, who like to go to ball games, who like to go shopping. We're no different than anybody else. Their door, bring them to the event, and then bring them home.
I think if there wasn't transportation, a van to pick them up, they wouldn't be going out at night.
If they were in a city, they might have access to bus routes and, you know, public transportation, the subway, whatever. Here, we're so spread out, transportation is difficult to come by at best.
All you want.
Recreation is very healthy. It's good for you physically as well as mentally. You need it.
It really changed my life. It opened new doors for me, and I was, you know, I feel normal, quote, normal.
You know, to keep the person, you know, on a balance, you know.
Everybody's got a smile, which is really brightens your day. You don't feel lonely. You have a camaraderie with the other members. That you don't have with other people.
You know, make good friends, you know, that you can relate to, you know, from, you know, staying out of trouble. You know, it won't be the wrong kind of people. It'd be the right kind, so.
Housing is important, yes. You have to have shelter and things like this. The job is very important, too, because you need finances. I think there should be more to life than just that. And I think to have a quote-unquote all-around person, I think they need fun sometimes.
They're out there enjoying themselves. They're socializing more. They're making friends. They're putting together support networks. And it just benefits them in many ways.
Hit the road, Jack. It's good for your mental illness to get involved in some kind of an activity.
If you dwell on inward on things and you have troubles, then it causes that depression to start to seep in. So that's why I like going to events, because it relieves, takes you away from the world around you.
My mother passed away in March of last year. I knew I needed something to do. I didn't get depressed or anything. I had time. I had a lot of outings to be involved in.
You know, I might wake up, you know, and in the morning and just say, you know, this is just not going to be my day, you know. And then look on the calendar and say, oh, I have something to do.
Part of the program is not just a fun program, it's also a learning program. By associating with other members, certain members will learn about grooming skills. You know, like, this person looks really neat. Maybe I can, you know, clean up a little bit. People do have a profound effect on other members of the program. Folks learn personal accountability. They learn responsibility.
I just looked up and seen the sign, work hard, play hard. I wanted to know how can I get involved.
The requirements for membership in Work Hard, Play Hard are as simple as being a consumer of mental health services here in the greater New London, Norwich area. Most of the folks get involved by word of mouth. Their friends tell them about Work Hard, Play Hard. It piques their interest. They see them going all the time. They want to be part of it. They talk about how much fun they have, the friends they make, the things they do. They can also be referred by other affiliate agencies of Southeastern Mental Health Authority. It sometimes takes a little longer to get one or two people acclimated to the program, but we do it in such a way where they feel safe and they feel encouraged and they feel wanted by the group, and then it usually works out very well for everybody.
Mostly I stay at home, have nothing to do.
I wouldn't be in the community as much if it wasn't for Work Hard, Play Hard.
Well, it would be harder on me. It would be a more stressful life.
It's just great for people and their way they form their friendships.
I just can't praise the program, the staff, and the people that participate enough.
I just think it's a great tool to just show everybody we're not as different as you think.
It's really a wonderful program, and I hope it stays around forever, because we really do need it, and I appreciate it.